Gonna do a video here of my my Yamaha HTR 5140, my Serwin Vega floor speakers, Polk Audio center channel, and then I got my my Polk Audio rear surrounds back there. I'm gonna do a video playing this scene from Law Abiding Citizen because has, you know, really good vocals, you know, for dialogue when he's talking and stuff. Sounds really good. So, hope you guys like it. Please leave me comments. All right, thanks.
I'm going to ask you some very simple and direct questions. I suggest that you answer them in the same fashion. Is your name Clyde Alexander Shelton?
Yes, sir.
And you've waived your right to counsel, correct?
Yes, sir.
You sure you want to do that?
Yes, sir.
Did you murder Clarence Darby?
I wanted him dead. He killed my wife and child.
Rupert Ames, did you murder him as well?
Rupert Ames deserved to die. They both deserved to die.
So you arranged both of those murders?
Yes, I planned it in my head over and over again. It took me a long time.
All right. I guess we're done here.
Counselor, you might want to cancel your 12:30 lunch with Judge Roberts.
Excuse me?
In fact, you might want to cancel the rest of the week because you're going to be busy. Sit down.
We're done here. We have your confession.
Oh, you do?
On tape. See, in our profession, we consider that a slam dunk.
Oh, really? I don't think so. Let's think back. What did I say? That I wanted to kill Clarence Darby? Yeah, sure. What father wouldn't? That both Darby and Ames deserved to die? I think most people would agree with that. That I planned it over and over again in my head? Yeah. Who wouldn't fantasize about that? None of these are an admission of guilt, Nick. You might want to check the tape.
We know you did it.
Well, it's not what you know. It's what you can prove in court. Didn't you tell me that once?
The only problem with your theory is that Darby's body was found on your property.
One of my many properties. An old abandoned warehouse, Nick. Junkies, they trespass there all the time. Isn't Darby involved in the drug trade? That's an unsavory world. I bet you a jury would agree, or perhaps someone was trying to frame me.
You know, Clyde, there's a lot of assholes in prison that thought they were smarter than me. Let's stop fucking around.
Nick, unless you have any hard evidence, then why are we even here? Why are we having this conversation? Well, that's easy. Now, you're the one who makes deals with murderers, yeah? So I've come to make mine. I will give you a confession, a real confession. You just have to give me something in return.
Yeah, well, since you are a murderer, what might that be?
A bed. But a nice bed.
I want a nice new one for myself.
Oh, I see. You're gonna have to deal with that because the one I have is lumpy, Nick. It's making me crazy.
Clyde, I think you got me confused with the detail people. See, I don't deal with prison conditions.
I believe those cots are bolted into the cells.
Well, that's what wrenches are for, dumbass. You know one of those new Duxiana beds with the adjustable, you know, the adjustable lumbar support?
I've seen the commercial.
That's the one I want.
Those are nice.
Because really, Nick, comes on late night. Frankly, I don't think I'm going to be able to focus on much of anything until I've had a good revitalizing night's sleep in my therapeutic Duxiana bed. So that's the deal. You give me my bed, you get your confession.
Okay. Let me think about that for a second. How about, fuck no.